thank you for coming back to Vinyl Soup, episode 2. And thank you for all the support and encouragement on our debut of Vinyl Soup. I got a lot of great advice, a lot of great comments, a lot of comments about my hair, a lot of comments in my DMs, and comments about what this squiggly line painting is. I don't know what it's supposed to be. It's a Jackson Pollock. It's a very old lithograph. Very old. That's Elvis, of course, one of one from the estate. But I want to thank everyone. You know, production isn't my strength. I'm not sure what my strength is, but I know production and lighting and all that isn't. But we have a lot of fun, and we're going to continue to try to get better. Now, before I get into Vinyl Soup, I just want to talk about, if you didn't watch the first episode, go watch it. It gives you a lot of background of how this started. But generally, what we're going to do is cover some news in music / vinyl. Talk about some of the trending topics in the vinyl community. That was on the streams or other videos. But then, most importantly, I'm going to highlight about 3 or 4 of your videos that I found interesting that I want other people to watch. So basically, that's how Vinyl Soup works. And it's pretty easy. And I encourage you again to watch the first one because it gives you a lot more background how this started and why we do it. So thanks again for coming back to Vinyl Soup. And let's get into the topics. Before we get into trending topics, I thought it'd be fun. Now that fan mail is pouring in since my first episode of the Vinyl Soup, I thought it'd be fun to open some fan mail live with you and share it with you. So I wouldn't call it an unboxing, but it is pouring in, and a couple of them are packages. So I'm going to open the very first package I received since starting Vinyl Soup. Here it is. And there's no return address, so it's kind of dangerous, but there's a letter. Just go ahead and read that. Dear Rev, congrats on the Vinyl Soup. Thank you. We heard you are looking for sponsors. I am. Here is a check for $5,000 to wear our t-shirt. We figure you could buy plenty of Glenlivet 18 with that. I could buy some. Your pals, the Jazz Bums. P.S. Thanks for doing less jazz reviews. It gives us more time to develop our review skills in order to get on the same level as you. That's right. Well, look at that. A jazz, this way, a Jazz Bum t-shirt. Now, it's a fine design. Got the old prestige label there. I'm gonna have to think about that. Okay, it's very generous, but as you know, this had no return address, and I am convinced that the Jazz Bums live in railroad cars and travel the country, okay? Travel the country buying jazz records nonstop. But I'm going to show you a little clip. I trade records occasionally with the Jazz Bums, and I would like to show you what it's like to get records from the Jazz Bums. Let's go to the footage. Okay, this is the Reverend Rock and Roll, and as promised, on location. And I'm gonna call this what it is. This is a goddamn exclusive, okay? You're not gonna get this at the Absolute Sound. You're not gonna get this at Analog Planet. You're certainly not gonna get this from Dizzy at the Tracking Angle, okay? I'm going to show you how I trade records, how I receive records from the Jazz Bums. I have told people over and over that the Jazz Bums live in railroad cars, okay? And they crisscross the country drinking homemade gin that they make with their obsession, all right? And I've been trading with them for well over 2 months. And in vinyl years, that's like 15 years. Now, it's important at this undisclosed location, this undisclosed Atlanta railroad crossing, that this is dangerous, okay? Do not try this at home. I have been doing this and arranged with the Jazz Bums for some time now to do this, but it's about time that people saw the Jazz Bums and what they're all about and how I get records from them. So we're just gonna sit here and we're gonna wait for the train. Once we hear it, we'll go into action and you'll see just how this works. Okay, there it is. Let's go, let's go, let's move. Jesus Christ, I never get used to that. All right, got the box from the jazz bones. Let's head back to the car. Okay, let's see what these guys sent me. It's amazing how they're always perfect. I just don't know how it happens. It's Keith Jarrett, Survivor Suite, super solid. George Benson, Beyond the Blue Horizon. That's a second pressing, guys, but I'll take it. Bill Evans, Quintessence. That's a goddamn hot stamper. They're throwing hot stampers off a train. John Handy, Projections. Art Ensemble of Chicago, Baptism, Hardcore. That's a good batch. I thought about it, and I took the cash. I took the cash. My first sellout. Vinyl Soup's first sellout. And I'm not going to lie, it feels good. It feels good. Now, as you can see from that clip on the site reporting, that I don't think anyone else does. I don't think there's another channel that does it. Doing business with the Jazz Bums is not for everyone. And thank God for those goddamn boxes from Acoustic Sounds and Chatty Kicks, because they're indestructible. You wouldn't be able to trade with the Jazz Bums without those boxes. So thank you, Jazz Bums. But more importantly, okay, I want to let you know that they stream every Friday. And their last stream is still up. Most of their streams are still up. And they break down the Hot Off the Press 2023 Tome Poet list. And there's some bangers in there. But let them give you some guidance and opinions on them, especially if you're new to jazz. These are a group of guys that are super knowledgeable, diverse backgrounds, ages, tastes, the whole nine yards. And in the Peanut Gallery, there's also a ton of knowledgeable people. And if you're a noob to jazz or wanting to learn more, it is a great place to start and ask questions. They're really friendly guys, and I think you'll enjoy it. So thank you very much, Jazz Bums. And I will continue the rest of the show proudly in this shirt. One of the first requests I got when I started the Vinyl Soup, when I just announced the Vinyl Soup, before I even recorded one episode, one of the requests I got was if I would please update people on what happened in the live streams, the vinyl community live streams throughout the week. And I thought that was a pretty good idea because not everyone's schedule, work, life allows them to jump on them all the time. Maybe they can only make the ones on the weekends. And not every week I think we'll really need an update in the Vinyl Soup and the live streams. And for many, not everyone is the backbone of their interaction with other people in this crazy hobby. The ability to jump on these streams, whether it be a box or in the Peanut Gallery. And I'm able to go in and out. I can participate sometimes in the Peanut Gallery. Most of the time I'm listening. And whether it's fun, it's informative, it's often hilarious, and it's a great way to interact with people. This week I definitely think needs an update. And I'm gonna do this with a qualifier. I'm not gonna give you my opinion, okay? I'm just going to tell you what happened for those who missed it and have a request at the end. Now, when this topic came up in the morning, when I saw it, it was going to be on Rachel's Ghost, a cold chill went through my body, much like when a ghost goes through your body. And I almost had that same trigger feeling of Mo-Fi Gate and the horror of Mo-Fi Gate when I saw that How You Clean Your Records was going to be the topic of the day. Because it started off innocently enough for me the night before when Norman Maslov, aka Mazzy, one of the most popular channels in the vinyl community, announced earlier in the week that he would be posting a video about his experiences with the Hummin' Guru. Now, that was really interesting to me because Mazzy's never been a record cleaner guy. Okay, I don't think he's ever cleaned his records. So that was going to be interesting. And he was going to do it with his roommate who has a degree in archival sciences. So you have a crazy record collector, like we're crazy record collectors, and this roommate with this tremendous knowledge and degree and background. So that's had my attention. I watched the video. It was charming. It was fun. And again, from the sample size, everyone and their mother has this machine now, this Humming Guru, okay? I don't have a different machine. And from the sample size I've seen, people love it. They like it. And now at this price point, it's relatively, depending on your budget, a real affordable way, potentially, to wash your records in a different way, a way that's currently very popular. And Mazzy liked the machine. He really, really liked it. So I finished the video and it was great. Really, really enjoyed it. One of his real better ones. And I woke up the next morning and that's when I saw the topic that was gonna be on Rachel's ghost, or the early conversation. That's when the chill, that's when that ghost went through my body. Because apparently the legend that is Michael Fremmer, a man who is an absolute deserving legend in vinyl playback and in this crazy hobby that we love, went hot and heavy into Mazzy's video, asking him, or demanding, I'm not sure, because his comments, I can no longer find his comments under Mazzy's video, asking him to take down that video because he was doing a disservice with that video on telling people how to clean their records. Now, I don't think Mazzy was telling, it was just showing what he was doing. Okay, and the controversy is in the formulation, what chemicals to put in, what chemicals not to put in. And within that live stream, Mike at the InGroove came in, who has tremendous experience with ultrasonic machines. He's got like 4 or 5 running all the time. He doesn't use chemicals, so he's very knowledgeable. I would say even an expert. Patrick, the vinyl archivist, who also is an expert to me, who does use a little bit of chemicals. And I think Mazzy was going off what Patrick was saying. Not Michael Fremmer is not accessible. He's a journalist. He's busy. He travels the whole world for this thing that we love. But then he ended up coming into the live stream. So it was absolutely incredible that this got incredibly informative, frustrating. I don't think we resolved how to wash or clean your records. And then Mazzy did a stream later on. I jumped on it briefly to see if Fremmer would get on there, because Fremmer's opinion is very important. But it got pretty heated at times. So that's what happened. That was the topic. Cleaning your records, washing records got hot and heavy. And it all started off from an innocent video from Mazzy, which was a fun one. And I'm glad he didn't take it down. And this stuff is evolving. How we do our records, the way people clean their records 40 years ago, 10 years ago, is not the same that they do it now, okay? But I do have a request that we spend the next 2 weeks arguing about record weights. And we're gonna throw these at each other. And whichever one hurts the most is the one I think we should all get. That's what I ask. And the other thing is, I have to say that a lot, this Humming Guru thing, as popular as it is, okay? I just want to people, you might not know this, but remind people that the Humming Guru people also brought us the Cinco toilet shower.
I'm a businessman. I travel constantly and often, and I do not have time to take showers and clean myself. The only opportunity I have is when I'm in airport bathrooms. That's why I chose the Cinco urinal shower system from Cinco. Just use a bungee cord to clamp the shower head to the urinal. Now I get nude. Don't be shy. I hope no one enters this room. Okay, ready to go. Just flush. The fresh water is redirected to create a unique horizontal showering experience. Just enough time to get clean. Cinco urinal shower contains two kinds of body wash and
shampoo. Hey, what is this? Turn it off, that water, man! Who you think clean all this mess up?
This is just a commercial. Chill out.
What I'm trying to say is I could go decades without this topic on how to clean your records. And really smart people proved to me, because lots of smart people were in this stream, that very smart people can disagree on this topic and probably be both right, okay? I kind of like the machines more than the formulation topic, because I like engineering, I like machines. But I think there's more than one way to do lots of things and still be right and still do it well. So let's not talk about it anymore. But let's get to the most important part of the vinyl soup, and it's your channels, your topics. And I'm going to start with this past week. You know, Rob Walker's vinyl tag has been wildly successful. Again, okay, maybe the most successful one. People really been enjoying it. I've been enjoying watching the videos. But one caught me off guard. Someone I only discussed or talked to in the peanut gallery, Nathanial Mars, comes out of left field, out of the stadium, past the parking lot, out of nowhere into the stadium with the most interesting and hysterical vinyl tag that I've seen. And I'm just going to show you a little clip now, and it'll speak for itself.
Vinyl community, how do you do? It's another lousy new year. That means it's time for the annual flurry of vinyl tag videos. A chance to shine a tiny spotlight on this stupid, overpriced hobby and the community of enablers surrounding it. We're given a list of 20 questions, and everybody makes a video with their answers. But these answers are the correct ones. So let's go.
My prediction is, if Nathanial Mars, okay, continues to make videos as that wolf, with that wit, with that knowledge, with that taste, apparently he lives in a record store, okay? Look at that room. That's a record store. Either he's creating some like cosplay record store in his house, or he has a record store. I've only interacted with him in the peanut gallery. But if he continues to make videos like that, he's gonna have 100,000 followers. I will demand that he gets to 100,000 followers, because that was a fantastic vinyl tag. It was hilarious, it was informative, and he lives in a record store. He cosplayed a record store. So please check out the rest of that video. It's absolutely fascinating. From what I last checked, that's the only video he's ever made, and he's fantastic in the peanut gallery. Knows a ton, and obviously is a lot of fun. So really enjoyed that. We've all experienced FOMO in this hobby to some degree. If you're a crazy record collector, you've experienced FOMO. And sometimes we feel like we're strong, resisting the buy now, cry later vibe. And other times we're more susceptible, and it could be because of an artist or a genre, anniversary edition, something, FOMO will come in. Christopher Daykin does a video on FOMO. And first of all, he has my favorite intro to any vinyl community channel out there.
My name's Chris, and I buy records.
My name's Chris, and I buy records. I don't know if that's like a Record Anonymous intro, but if 99% of the time, if you say, my name's Chris, and I buy records, I don't care who you are. If you say that, I'm going to listen to you. I'm going to listen to you because you're one of me. You're one of me. But I really like the way he talks about FOMO in a really honest, reflective way, an inner way. And he does it with such sincerity that it has my attention, that it makes me think how I'm buying, when I've been susceptible, how am I susceptible? But he's really reflective also on the state of the economy in the UK, in England, and what's going on, obviously, in other parts of Europe. The war in Ukraine is just horrendous, and it's affecting energy prices and commodity prices and basic need prices. And there's a lot going on with strikes and a lot of people coming out of COVID, whether it be the national health system or other aspects that have been taxed. So there's a lot of stress right now around the world. And so that's a good time to dial in and talk about FOMO. And I think he really does it. And he talks about, to me, what really I found sentimental was he talks about a record he got from his mother, one that he always wanted. And the comparison and the ideas of different pressings. But to me, I've received in my adult, like now years, I've received a few records from my mother, and I treasure those much more than I did from the records I got when I was a little kid from my mom. It's different now. It's different. Time's shorter now with her and me. And it really made me think how much I love my mother and how grateful I am that she took the time to give me records, even at this age. That's not what FOMO is about. It's about the music, of course, but it's also the attachments and the connections you bring together, are brought together with music. So I think his video is one of my favorite videos about FOMO, and I'm gonna link it below, and I think you really will like it and should watch it. When 2023 hit, one of the things I did was review all the subscriptions that I have. and they just sneak up on you now. Okay? They compound like interest. There's so many. BMW, I think last year announced that in their newer models, there would be a subscription service to heat your seats. To heat the frickin' seats in your car, there'd be a service, a sub for that. It's just more and more. And they obviously are in our hobby too. I've been a member of Vinyl Me Please forever, for a long time. And I just recently canceled. Because like the other things, I just want to try new things. I just want to try different content and maybe just lower costs. I don't know. I just was ready for a change. And after I did that, after particularly I canceled Vinyl Me Please, there are other services that I've been interested in, but I find them a bit intimidating because of where the music's coming from, but also what the music is and the service and is it a value or not. And then out of nowhere, Motorik does a video on SoundOhm, the subscription service. And SoundOhm is a music provider, a store. I think it does reissues itself, if I'm right. I might not have that right. Out of Italy. And I've always been fascinated with it. And I don't have too many local friends into experimental music or avant-garde or what have you. For the most part, I'm a normie, but I really love learning about this stuff, especially music, new genres that I've never been exposed to. And SoundOhm is amazing. But Motorik does an amazing job breaking down how it works, how they ship, the thresholds you need to meet to, in order for this to be a value. He compares it also to sites you might know like Dusty Grooves and others where they sell locally experimental music or even to the Bandcamp of the artists, how that compares. And if SoundOhm is a good value, and I've talked in the past with Fred Putterman, and there are clever ways, I think, to work this membership, but overall, is it a value for the individual? And I think it's great in this hobby to be exposed to new things, to new types of music, to new angles and points of view in music. And SoundOhm does that so well. But again, I found it intimidating. So check out his video, I'll link it below, and maybe it's something you'll be interested in for 2023. We'll get you out on this quick one because the video is quick too. I'm going to send you over to Sweden, to Jonas, Sublimedia. And most of you are probably already following him. If you're not, you should. Not just because of the video I'm going to talk about, because of all his videos. I feel like when I watch Jonas's videos, I try to deconstruct them because they're so beautiful and the lighting, the aesthetic is perfect and his presentation, and his personality. What I'm trying to say, Jonas, is I'm jealous. Just incredible videos. And this one, though, this one, I'm a little selfish, just when we're talking about FOMO. He does a book that I got last year for Christmas. I used to kind of have a coffee table book problem a long time ago. I kicked that, thankfully. Kicked it hard. So I just have a few that I treasure now. And this is one of them. Absolutely one of them. And he does a much better job than I can presenting it. And it covers such incredible eras of music, and the photography is just tremendous. And again, watch his video because he's better than me, but more importantly, connect to his channel because his videos are a knockout and you really, really enjoy them. So Jonas covering this book, I think I gave away, it's not a surprise anymore. And thank you for watching The Vinyl Soup and for the encouragement. And I'll keep doing this if you want me to. Take care, y'all.